Hi guys, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
In the previous video of Kotlin Fundamentals, we just executed hello world on a command line and saw the whole compilation process. But even as I was writing this, I am sure some of you were wondering why this main function not defined in a class, because that's how you write a main function in Java program, because at the end of the day, if this Kotlin file is getting compiled into a JVM bytecode, that is what it is supposed to look like. And if that particular class file is getting created, what is the name of that particular class file? Well, in this video, we will try to explore that and try to understand that part of Kotlin compilation process. To do that, I will be now moving to a IDE which is called as IntelliJ. IntelliJ is a very well-known IDE from the JetBrains. They are the same people who create the Android Studio IDE and have created Kotlin programming language. So let's open IntelliJ. IntelliJ is free of cost. You can just download it, Google it. So as you start the IntelliJ, this is how it looks like. And I will create a new project. Click on Kotlin as the framework. Click next. And here you can select Kotlin/demo project and click finish. And that should basically create a project space, a folder name called as demo project. And right now it doesn't have any Kotlin file. So here we will create a new Kotlin file, call it as sample. And as you can see here, it gets created with the .kt extension. And then I will write a function called as main. This main function will take an argument which is of array string type, and inside this I'm going to write print hello Kotlin, and let's try to run it. For the first time, it will take some time for you to configure the whole build process, but once that is done, you should be able to see your output as hello Kotlin. If you are interested in learning what Java file corresponding to this particular Kotlin file would look like, you can go to tools, Kotlin, show Kotlin bytecode. It will start showing you the corresponding bytecode that is getting generated. You can't make much sense of this. So what you can do is click on JVM target it and click on decompile. And what you actually see here is corresponding Java code that gets generated for your Kotlin code. So for the sample.kt file, you basically create a class which is a public final class called as sample.kt. And for the main function that you have implemented in the Kotlin file, that gets translated into a public static final void main method that you typically write in your Java class. So this is how the converted Kotlin code looks like. You need not worry about all this metadata. More or less, Kotlin file gets converted into a class file, and any function that is defined in that particular Kotlin file becomes a static final method in that particular Java class. So let's add another function here, say hello and print saying hello. And once again, go to Kotlin and click on show Kotlin bytecode and click on decompiler. And as you can see here, for another function that we added here, it created another static final method. This just gives you a very basic idea of how Kotlin code gets converted into a Java code. This is very important because Kotlin and Java are interoperable. If you create a Java code, you should understand how that needs to be accessed in the Kotlin code. And if you have written some Kotlin code, how you need to invoke that in the Java code. If you understand in the background how a Kotlin file gets compiled into a Java class file, you will be able to do it in a much more understanding manner. This is just for knowledge purpose. In the future, when we get into a much more advanced scenarios where we are interoperating between Java and Kotlin, this knowledge will come in handy. In the next video, we will formally get started with all the various concepts that you associate with any programming language, like control flows, variables, constants, functions, classes, inheritance, interfaces. So stay tuned.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.